Rolling record.
Bring up bars and tone.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fade in graphic.
10, 9, ask for music. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Your worries and your strife.
And welcome to Bear Scares. We are here with our guest, Hunter, a noted wildlife enthusiast and a bear attack survivor. So, welcome to the show, Hunter.
Thank you for having me here, Tim.
Now, Hunter, you gotta tell me, how is the recovery process after your terrible accident?
Bring up camera.
The recovery process has been all right.
How are your levels looking, Anthony?
Food for us, and
it seems low.
The starry night sky, when I go to sleep, as well as the leaves rustling and the crickets chirping, that light helps me, that helps me get my mind off things.
Well, I'm glad that you're on the road to recovery, and that you look much better than you did months ago. So, Hunter, I've been led to believe that you've been in the forest for about 32 years now.
Yeah.
How's the Wi-Fi? Like, do you even get Wi-Fi?
Well, I technically have to rely on the hikers and campers that turn on the hotspots on their phone, and then I just grab my iPad, and then connect to their hotspot, and then just stream YouTube from that.
So, you're taking Wi-Fi from them? Is that what you're telling me?
Yeah, it's their loss.
3 minutes to the studio out.
Okay, anyways, so if you're all right with sharing, how did the bear attack happen?
Well, I was going for a walk with some friends, and then I noticed at the bottom of the hill, I noticed a bear, and I was like, that bear looks familiar, so I get closer to him, and I noticed that it's my friend Paul, or was my friend Paul at the time.
Ready cam, three, in cam
Paul?
Three.
Ready yeah.
Cam one. What do you mean, Burning Paul?
The bear's name is Paul. We went to high school together.
What? You went to high school with a bear?
Yeah.
Ready cam two. Bring in cam two.
All right. So you went to high school with a bear. His name's Paul. Why did he attack you then?
Ready cam one.
I called his mom a salmon head.
2 minutes.
I thought, and he used to be like, and Paul actually used to be like a cool kid in high school. He was very chill. And he was very fun to be around, and he was one of my closest friends back then, and I thought he would take that joke very lightly like he would have in high school, but apparently the opposite happened.
Ready cam three, bring in cam three, and I'll stretch it out.
So he attacked you, and you just, like, do you know him still? Do you know him now?
Ready cam
30 to the out.
I think he's made it pretty clear that he doesn't want to be friends with me ever again.
All right, so let's talk about your wild. Let's talk about the forest. You've been living there for 32 years. Like, what do you do when you get cold? Like,
I usually like gather some leaves and like try and cover myself with them. And worst case scenario, like dig a tunnel and like get myself under the dirt.
Okay. Anyways, well, that's all the time we have today, folks. Remember, don't trust a bear even if you went to high school with them. And also, thank you all for listening to Bear Scares. I love you all. Don't forget to give yourself a big bear hug.
39, 37, 36, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Now when you pick a pawpaw or a prickly pear, and you prick a raw paw, well, next time, beware. Don't pick the prickly pear by the paw. When you pick a pear, try to use the claw. But you don't need to use the claw when you pick a pear of the big paw. Have I given you a clue? The bare necessities of life.
Stop tape.
Studio clear.